guys, welcome to today's video. So today I'm going to be talking about The Ordinary, which is one of my favorite skincare brands to talk about here on my channel. And I have a lot of videos if you are new here. I have a lot of product reviews. I also share a lot of skincare routines that target certain skin types and concerns just using products from The Ordinary. So definitely go and check those out if you haven't seen those yet. But in today's video, I'm actually going to be sharing my most repurchased products. And these are also products that I use the most on a weekly basis. So I have 7 products here in total that I thought I would share. And so if you are curious to see what products those are, then please keep on watching. So I have tried and tested a lot of products from The Ordinary, and over the years I have accumulated my favorites, the ones that perform the best on my skin, also the ones that I see the best results with. Now, if you are new to my channel, I have normal to combination skin, and so when I'm looking for skincare products, I'm looking for anti-aging products, of course, to help target signs of aging for prevention. I'm also looking for products that will help with hyperpigmentation, as well as adding more hydration into my skincare routine, because sometimes I can experience dryness and irritation when using tretinoin. So when it comes to The Ordinary, these 7 products truly help with all of those skin concerns. And the first product that I'm going to be sharing first is The Ordinary Pycnogenol 5%. Now, this is actually a product that is underrated. I don't hear a lot of people talk about this. I'm not sure if it's because a lot of people are not familiar with what pycnogenol is, but this is an antioxidant, and this serum is great for many things. So the number one being great for anti-aging, great to fight signs of aging, also to help with prevention. This is also a great ingredient to incorporate in your morning routine to help protect your skin from environmental stressors that is caused by pollution. Any type of antioxidant product will help to protect your skin from free radical damage. This is also a product that you can incorporate in your routine to add more hydration. So this will be great to apply on its own, or you can apply a couple of drops of this into your moisturizer, which is how I like to use it. You can use this every day, twice a day, or you can just use it when needed, which is what I typically do. So 1 to 2 times a week, I will incorporate this into my moisturizer to add more hydration and to make my skin feel more moisturized and more comfortable. Now, this is also a product that you can incorporate with your vitamin C serum. Now, if you have a vitamin C at home, specifically a pure form of vitamin C, like L-ascorbic acid or ascorbic acid, these types of vitamin C's can oxidize pretty quickly. Now, if you have a vitamin C that is starting to oxidize, or it's pretty much oxidized, you can actually mix a couple of drops of the pycnogenol into your vitamin C serum, of course, all in the palm of your hand. And the pycnogenol can actually help to recycle oxidized vitamin C, where it will make the vitamin C more effective again. And a lot of people don't know that when it comes to pycnogenol. So even if you don't use this on its own for anti-aging or to add more hydration to your skin, this will be a great product to have on hand in case your vitamin C starts to oxidize. And I think that is so cool. And I think it's great to have in your skincare routine, just even for that reason alone. So I really do like this. I've been using this now for a couple of years, and this is also a product that is not greasy. It's also not sticky. It does have an oily feel to it, even though it is oil-free. It's also water-free as well. It does have this color to it. This does not stain clothing or your face. From my experience, I've never ever experienced any type of staining, and this never ever pills with my skincare products. So it sits nice underneath makeup and sunscreen, but it's also lovely to use every day, twice a day if you need to. The next product is The Ordinary Resveratrol 3% plus ferulic acid 3%. This is actually one of my favorite products from The Ordinary, and this is also another antioxidant that The Ordinary offers. Now, this is similar to pycnogenol, but this one would be best suited for signs of aging as well as for prevention also. Again, this will also help to protect your skin from environmental stressors. Now, I am a big fan of ferulic acid, which this contains 3%. A lot of my vitamin C serums also contain ferulic acid. And ferulic acid can actually help boost the effects of other types of antioxidants when paired in the same skincare routine. So I like to use this in my morning routine with my vitamin C serum, as well as any other type of antioxidant serum that I would like to also incorporate. They all enhance one another, and you can see beautiful, quick results by doing this. Now, if resveratrol isn't a serum that you want to incorporate in your morning routine, you can use this in your evening routine paired up with your retinol or even your retinoid tretinoin. This pairs up really well with that, and I've done that several times before, and I also liked that combination as well. This is also hydrating. It does have that oily texture as well, but this is oil-free, and you can use this every day, twice a day, if you want to. The third product is The Ordinary Hyaluronic Acid 2% plus B5, another great option when it comes to The Ordinary. This can help to attract and hold on to 1,000 times its weight in moisture. So if you're using this correctly, which you should be applying this to damp skin and then sealing it in with a moisturizer afterwards, this can really help to give you a plumper look to your skin, and your skin can also feel more hydrated as well. So if you're into hyaluronic acid, I highly recommend this one. This one is great. The fourth product is The Ordinary Argireline Solution 10%, which is one of the peptides that The Ordinary has to offer. Now, I've been using this for several months, and I've been very consistent with this, with using it every single night, and I apply this to my crow's feet area as well as my forehead lines. Now, this is great to target signs of aging. A lot of people say this is Botox in a bottle, where this will help to smooth out those dynamic folds. Now, the fine lines that I had on my crow's feet have definitely smoothed out. They're not as prominent. My fine lines are still there, but it has definitely improved them since being consistent with this. And that's the key thing. You want to be consistent with all of your skincare products so that you can see potential results. Now, you can use this all over your face and your neck, or you can just spot treat your problem areas like your forehead lines, your 11s, your nasolabial folds, the lines above your lip, wherever you want to treat. You can treat it. And I think this is really, really effective. You can use this with your retinol, with your tretinoin. You can also pair this up with other types of peptides as well. And by doing this, this will really help to boost the effects of all of them, where you can see quicker results. I also have another peptide here, which is the Buffet. Now, I've been using this serum for a very long time, and I always resort back to it because it contains multiple different types of peptides. So you can find Matrixyl in here. You can also find Argireline, and if you want to use this with the Argireline solution, that would be a lovely combination, but it's not necessary to do that. Now, this sits really nice underneath makeup and sunscreen. I use this more so in my evening routine though, with my tretinoin. I like to use this on my neck to help with fine lines and wrinkles, and this one also contains hyaluronic acid, which will give you that plumper look as well. So I really, really love this one also. The next product is The Ordinary Lactic Acid 10% plus hyaluronic acid. Now, I like to use this once a week, maybe once every couple of weeks, to really help remove that dead flaky skin that tretinoin has caused. And this does a really good job to remove that. Now, I have normal decombination, like I said, and really, for this skin type, glycolic acid is a great acid to choose. But I find glycolic acid to be a little bit too sensitizing and harsh, even for my skin type. And so I always resort to lactic acid, specifically from The Ordinary, because I feel like this is gentle, but very effective. And if you're starting out with lactic acid, I would suggest starting with the 5% and then work your way to the 10 if that is what you want to do. And if you are more on the sensitive side, then you may want to choose The Ordinary Mandelic Acid, which I really love as well, but I tend to resort to this one more so for my exfoliation process. So this is another product that I use quite a bit, also another product that I have repurchased a lot as well, and I highly recommend if you haven't tried this already. And the last product is The Ordinary Amino Acids Plus B5. I have talked a lot about this product on my channel, and this is honestly my most repurchased and my most used as well, especially over the years. I like to use this more so during the fall winter months because this is going to add more hydration into your skincare routine. And I do like to use it all year round, and right now I'm using this a couple of days a week, especially when I need it, when my skin is feeling a little bit tight and and dry, but this will be great to use every single day no matter what skin type you have. You can use this twice a day as well, and I would recommend using this after cleansing or after you have used your toner and essence, because this is honestly like water. It absorbs into your skin pretty quickly. You also want to apply this to damp skin as well for better absorption, and no different than hyaluronic acid, you do want to seal it in with a moisturizer just to keep that hydration in. This won't necessarily give you plump skin like hyaluronic acid, as they are very different products. This is also quite different than pycnogenol as well, even though pycnogenol will also add more hydration. But I feel like if you want something for every day and something to really make your skin feel moisturized and hydrated, the Amino Acids Plus B5 will be a great option. And again, this is another product from The Ordinary that is underrated. I honestly don't hear a lot of people talk about this either, and this is such a lovely, lovely serum, and I have purchased a lot of these. I don't even know how many now, I've lost count, but it's a lot. It really is. And when I purchase this, I always purchase backups as well, like 3 or 4 at a time, because it truly is one of those products that I always resort to. Yeah, I love it. So that completes today's video. Those are the 7 products that I use the most, and they never disappoint me. I have seen incredible results with these as well, and I highly recommend, especially if you're looking for products to help fight signs of aging and to also help with hydration as well. These are great options to look into when it comes to The Ordinary skincare line. So thank you so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. Don't forget to subscribe and ring that notification bell so that you don't miss out on any of my upcoming videos. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up, as it truly helps my channel. And I will see you all in my next video. Take care. I'll see you guys then. Bye guys.